The location for the proposed operations of government tax collection facility has been identified. Officials say there were many factors determining the chosen site, described commonly as City 2000. Carla Palmer reports.
The government's tax collection agency is now headquartered on Carmichael Road, just at the rear of Scotiabank. The two-story facility is being described as a one-stop shop by Financial Secretary John Rowe.
This building really is the home for the Central Revenue Administration. And so for all intents and purposes, that business license, collection of property tax, collection of VAT, they're all going to be operating out of this premises. Now, because a lot of what people do in relation to VAT and business licenses also involve interaction with national insurance, there's a small amount of space to accommodate some NIB services.
Rowe says the chosen site was by no means a random selection, but rather a calculated decision, taking into account the size of the property for parking purposes to inside the facility, which he noted was built to specifications.
There is a lease arrangement for the building, as part of the lease arrangement, we would have had a lot of the preparation of the space done to the government specification. This will be a great step up for persons who have to fight the congestion of the city and parking. And there is a property surrounding the facilities that we're looking to for providing some more parking.
Mr. Rowe also highlighted that accommodations have also been made for aftercare of employees' children, which he regards as a necessity, leading to the continued high level of productivity of those public servants working from that building. Additionally,
the meeting room facilities here will make it a lot easier for people to have the remote connection, say for video conferencing and the like. That's going to be important for New Providence in terms of Grand Bahama, Bimini, Abaco and some of the other centers where we're going to have our satellite operations.
Rowe anticipates the building being completed in time for the targeted move-in deadline of August. Initially, he expects over 100 employees to move into the premises, with the number increasing steadily. Carla Palmer, ZNS Network News.